Hello, good day everyone. My name is Larry Kidd and I'm an MSW ambassador working for the Mountain SeaWorld platform. You're welcome to my YouTube channel. Please make sure you like and subscribe so as to get more related content. Now today we'll be talking about NFT leasing and how does it work. Now just the way you can lease any other thing like real estate or crypto, you can also lease NFTs on an NFT platform. If maybe you don't have enough money to purchase the NFT or you don't actually want to own the NFT permanently, just want to own it for a period of time, you can actually rent some special NFTs. And in this video we'll be showing you how the whole process works. Now NFT borrowing is NFT lending is like borrowing an NFT for a period of time, and this is made possible through the use of a smart contract which mostly requires a deposit. So during the time that the NFT is with the person that rents it, the owner of the NFT will collect a particular rental fee throughout the rental period. Now why do people rent NFTs? First, NFT owners rent out NFTs as a source of income. You can actually make money from your valuable NFTs by putting them out for lease and making other NFT users around the world, you know, rent your NFT for a particular period of time and pay for your NFTs. Now another reason is because of the high cost of NFTs. Now a lot of valuable NFTs are also very expensive, and the user of the NFT might not want to use it for a long period of time, so they will just, you know, decide to rent the NFT instead of paying the actual, you know, amount to buy the NFT. Then we have the need for flexibility. You know, a lot of users want to use different kind of NFTs and they don't really want to, you know, use it for a long period of time. You can't spend, you know, a large amount of money to buy an NFT you won't be needing at the end of the day. Then we have lack of storage space. So some NFT owners don't really have enough storage space to store their valuable NFTs, so they end up renting out their NFTs to users all across the world so that those users that rent them will store them for a particular period of time while the NFT is available for rent. Then we have the desire to try before buying. Like most NFT users are skeptical about buying NFTs, like they want to try the NFTs first before, you know, they buy the NFTs. So that's why a lot of people rent the NFTs they want to buy first to test it out and see how it is before they put the actual amount out to buy it. Now we have two types of NFT renting. We have collateral renting and we have collateral-less renting. Now in collateral renting, the NFT owner places their digital assets on a market that allows NFT enthusiasts to borrow it. So if the renter finds the NFT and is interested in using it, they can proceed to rent the NFT through a smart contract under the... So both the borrower and the lender are under a term of agreement. Right, the second type of NFT renting is the collateral less renting, like whereby there's no money based on the renting. The renting is like collateral less renting is similar to collateral based renting, but it offers a significant benefit to both the asset owner and the renter, and the NFT does not necessitate lenders to give up a collateral. Like you don't have to drop a collateral to borrow the NFT, unlike the first type of NFT lending, which is the collateral-less lending. Now, what kind of platforms can you borrow NFTs on? I'm going to be talking about the MSW platform, which is the number one platform where you can borrow NFTs on. And for more information about MSW, you can go to www.mountainseaworld.io. You can also follow our Telegram channels, our Discord channels, and our Twitter, and to get more information about NFTs and crypto in general. Now, that's all we have about NFT lending. In my next video, I'll be talking about a very different topic. So make sure you like and subscribe. Thank you for watching my video. Good day.